Larry in the dressing room. Cooney still in his dressing room. Larry getting ready to come out. And Larry blowing a kiss to all of you who are watching. But inside, you gotta know that he has a normal human being's normal doubts and maybe even fears. And the same, of course, is totally true of Gerry Cooney. The crowd is here now. I don't see an empty seat in the house. And I tell you, if this fight carries with it in execution the fascinating conjecture that has gone into it in the preparation, then we'll have an evening of boxing. Already we have had two bouts. Wilfredo Gomez successfully retaining his super bantamweight crown. And as you just saw, Trevor Burbick decisioning young Greg Page. Promoter Don King has to be disappointed about the Page outcome. Gerry Cooney is apparently heading out of his dressing room, but he has not come in within the arena proper as yet. Just above us, television cameraman within the ring. This is music for Gerry Cooney, Rocky's theme. Gerry talks often about Rocky II, about how Rocky's wife woke up. Her first words were, "We won, we won." And he said, he walks down the aisle to the ring, that's what he's going to be thinking. Here's a huge kid. He borders on being 6'7". That's an inch and three quarters taller than Primo Carnera. You remember when he was regarded as the behemoth because of his size? For the first time in his life, Larry Holmes will have to punch upward. Kenny Norton thinks it may be a problem. That remains to be seen. As you look at Gerry Cooney coming down, remember he is a fighter who fights just one way. He comes at you. He relies solely and completely upon the devastating power of his left hook. His trainer Victor Valley says that a right has been developed to go with it. But that right has yet to be shown. A left hook, it can crush you wherever it hits you. But perhaps his most pulverizing blow is the left hook to the liver area. It completely debilitates a man who receives it. Now to the music. Approaches the ring. The crowd stands, and Gerry takes the time to laugh and cheer with him. When the March 15th date was put off because of his shoulder, some conjectured that it was fear on Cooney's part. In fairness to Gerry, I have never seen any opponent, not even any fighter, not even Ali, more composed. So Gerry Cooney is in the ring. Cooney in the ring, over in his corner, directly across the ring from us. Gordon Jones and Dennis Rappaport, the co-managers, and Victor Valley, the trainer, all over there around him. Larry Holmes is just now leaving the dressing room. Such and Larry Holmes's emergence from his dressing room and to the area within the arena proper, there will be Larry Holmes music. Comes the music for Larry Holmes. Recognize the pop tune? Ain't no stopping us now. Here's the championship belt being carried aloft. The Holmes entourage. Down the aisle. Larry Holmes is actually trotting down the aisle. I will stop him in seven. If he's foolish, he'll go in four. That's Holmes' prediction. Gerry Cooney, no prediction, only I'll win. There's been so many things held us down, but now it looks like things are finally coming around. I know the first three rounds will be the test, it seems to me, for Holmes. Will he box? Will he box? Or will he fall prey to Cooney's type of fight? And there he is. Larry Holmes is in the ring looking at the opponent. Gerry Cooney looking equally back at Larry Holmes. Usually, fighters express dislikes for each other, are part of the promotional hype routine. I do not believe for a minute that has been true in this case. Each of these men, however wrongly or by their precepts, however rightfully, dislikes the other, and with a vengeance.
Ladies and gentlemen, the officials.
And here is Chuck Hull for the introduction.
Athletic Commission for the next contest. The judges are Dwayne Ford, Dave Moretti, and Jerry Roth. The timekeeper is Charlie Roth. Counting at the knockdowns, Jane Broadfoot. The attending physicians at ringside, Dr. Donald Romeo and Dr. Flip Omansky. And the referee is Mills Lane. This is the main event of the evening. 15 rounds of boxing for the WBC Heavyweight Championship of the World. Introducing, in the red corner, fighting from Easton, Pennsylvania, weighing 212 and one-half pounds, the undefeated WBC Heavyweight Champion of the World, the Easton Assassin, Larry Holmes. The blue corner, fighting out of Huntington, New York, weighing 225 and one half pounds. He is undefeated in his professional career. He is ranked number one by both the WBA and the WBC. Introducing, gentlemen, Gerry Cooney. 15 rounds of boxing.
So the fighters have been introduced. Cooney, a huge favorite out here. It must be noted in perfect frankness that some ugliness has surrounded the anger between the two men, and both men are right. The ugliness relates to bringing in the issue of racism and the great white hope. As Cooney said, we're Americans. No, Cooney will not now look at him. He will look down. Holmes, it's going to be a good fight. Cooney did not look at him. Note, Mills Lane, so tiny between them. Mills Lane, a good, confident, experienced referee. But how can a man that size contain the two huge men who are the fighters? How can he use the physical control that may be necessary? The bout begins. Holmes quickly seeking movement, flicking the left in. I'm a boxer, he says, and that's what I'm going to do. Cooney, much better defensive fighter than given credit for. Again, the left sneaks in. But always the need to be careful. Left to the midsection. Thunderous power in Cooney. You have to respect it. Just coming up to the minute mark in the first round. 1 minute of action. Holmes, a moving target. Cooney has not faced any. Not Young, not Lyle. Not Kenny Norton. Minute and a half gone. In the round. Cooney stalking. Nothing graceful about Gerry. Never had to be. Holmes. Total concentration in his eyes. Totally intent. Cooney with a slightly low blow, unintentional. And Holmes spun him around. Cooney with his first pair of jabs. You see that right of Cooney's? It landed on Holmes' arm. He can deaden the fighter's arm. In the manner of Rocky Marciano, the late Rocky. The stars that couldn't lift his arms. They were black and blue for Marciano's boots. Counting down toward the end of round one. Again, that blow. A touch low. Holmes answering back with the left. Approach the end of the round. Very excited. Some profanity, which you heard. But the basic lesson to Cooney, keep cool. Keep cool. And then he demeaned Holmes' prowess as an opponent. Victor Valley. Three rounds should be telltale for Holmes, because that's when his boxing skills should be able to take over. I am just told that this is the hottest day of the year in Las Vegas. Now right now at ringside we are at 92 degrees, but with the lights up it has to be over 100 in that ring. Thus the importance of stamina if this fight goes on. Minute 40 left in round two. Left shoulder, which caused the postponement, subjected to a series of stress tests 2 days ago, held up perfectly. walking, Holmes dancing, lots of movement. A good blow by Holmes, a good right. And it's called a knockdown. It is called a knockdown. Holmes scored with the right, and Cooney went down. The first knockdown of the fight. But the knockdown by Holmes, not by Gerry Cooney. The right caught him. But Cooney put him off balance, and down he went, stunned. Look at that knockdown in replay. Now watch here. The left started. Cooney opened for that right. He had blocked the left, brought it down, left himself open for the right. You could see he was stunned. He struggled to regain his balance, but he went down. All right, another angle. The right getting in cleanly. The left he had held, the right went down, Cooney's right went down. He dropped it after Holmes had his left blocked by that right. Still another replay. But notice, Cooney's left was not positioned properly for defense because the left was at the side of his face, not in front of it. And Holmes could get right through to it. The bell for round three. This crowd is still stunned itself by the suddenness with which Cooney went down. What Holmes has to be wary about is the same thing that Sugar Ray Leonard had to be wary about against Tommy Hearns. Sugar Ray sitting right down the aisle from me. And that is, be careful. Don't leave yourself open because you've got it. Leonard might have knocked Hearns out in the sixth round, but he wouldn't chance. Hearns is right. Cooney was angered by being knocked down. He continues to stalk Holmes. Holmes continues to move, to use the whole ring. Floyd Patterson had an excellent analysis of this fight. He said, this fight depends on whether or not Cooney works the ring. Or rather Holmes, how Holmes fights the fight. Cooney trying to pull his way in there to land, to devastate Holmes with that enormous power. Remember, the best place for the left hook for Cooney is really the liver area, although it's pulverizing anyway. As Holmes continues to get that left jab in there, it does thwart and frustrate Cooney a little bit. Accumulatively, it will slow Cooney down if Holmes can continue successfully to execute. Less than a minute left of the third round. I don't know how this fight's going to turn out, obviously, but I have never seen Holmes so purposeful. Never. Couple of bluffs. An exchange of words for the first time in that round. Holmes, still the boxer. Let's listen to Holmes' question. Wisdom in that corner, the octogenarian Ray Arcel, who had so much to do with the greatness of Roberto Duran when Duran was great, and of course 65-year-old or 67-year-old Eddie Futch, the man who cared about his fighter, who wouldn't let Joe Frazier come out for the 15th round when Joe was all but blinded. The bell now, round four. This is Holmes against Cooney. Holmes, boxing, fighting his fight thus far. One knockdown by Holmes in the second round. A right did it, and Holmes is using his right effectively. There is anger in Cooney. There is fire in him, too. And there is always the threat of that power. That's the left side, the liver area. Another left got in there. Remember, this fight is scored by three judges, no voice in the scoring by the referee. It's a 10-point must system of scoring per round. Green knockdown rule is in. It's waived now. This is championship direction. Mandatory 8-point. Holmes continuing to use the jab. Holmes doubling with the left there. The jab. Cooney in this round is beginning to connect with some of those blows to the body. Got into the belt. A good right by Cooney. A much better round for Cooney. A much better round. Another good right by Cooney. Cooney's coming on in this round. Cooney the aggressor. And if Holmes didn't know he was in a fight, he knows it now. Double jab, and go to that body. You can see the confidence grow in Cooney in that fourth round. The test of such huge physical strength, not the skills and experience of Holmes. Who had the theory that the longer this fight went, the better it would be for Holmes. We'll find out about Cooney and the question of stamina. And we'll also find out if Holmes goes down, can he get up against a finisher like Cooney? And can he keep moving for 15 rounds as he verges on 33? These are the intangibles going into this fight that made it loom as fascinating. This is the fifth round. Gerry Cooney beginning in the fourth round. Began to make his fight. Holmes has not been able to make Cooney go backwards, even though he did floor him in the second round. Minute 40 into round five. A quick right by Holmes. Cooney was open for it. Holmes has used his right very well tonight. Uses his left to try again the right to Cooney. And Cooney made a remark to Holmes. I don't know exactly what it was, but he certainly is talking to Holmes now and not in a friendly way. Seconds left. Round five. One knockdown in the fight. Second round. Holmes knocked Cooney down. Did it with a right. Double. Double up, Valley told him, with the left jab, and that's what Cooney's doing. I take the title away from you. Round action. Holmes with the flicking left jab, the lead, setting up the right. Again, the left gets in there. Gerry trying to use the left. That time picked off. That time too. The right. Right connected. Holmes laughing. But it's a false laugh, as it is with Cooney. Fear of failure haunts a fighter before he gets into the ring. All fighters, they'll tell you. Touch gloves with the right thing. He'll blame the referee. Bridge of it, showing marked redness from the many Holmes lefts. With every Cooney blow, because they knew, they sensed the enormous power in his body. That right to the Holmes midriff was Cooney's best blow of the night. That right that he just threw was a beauty. A right. Victor Valley said to me, Gerry's right will be the dominating blow of the fight. He will astound Holmes with his right. Angie Dundee used to call Gerry a one-armed bandit, saying he can only fight with the left. Cooney getting it now from Holmes. For a moment looked like Gerry might go down. Holmes is really laying it all over. Cooney is not in good shape. Suddenly a Holmes attack. And Cooney fought out of it.
to the left as the round ended. Let's look at the Cooney right. That's the right. But Holmes fought back. You see the bridge of Cooney's nose? Holmes fought back with this flurry, and Cooney was hurt and appeared momentarily ready to go down, but he didn't. He lost control of himself, actually physically. And Holmes moved him all over the ring. Look at it again. That's when Cooney's inexperience shows, and the fact that he is not a good boxer. So that's the way it was in the sixth round. Cooney also has a cut. The left eye. Bridge of the nose is red as a beet. The left eye is cut. Holmes, after getting hit by Cooney's best blow, look at the cut. And it's still flowing blood. It's in the very corner of the left eye. It is an ugly gash. Holmes fought back from Cooney's right and really leveled Cooney with a bevy of blows. Cooney appeared ready to go down. He has gone down once. That was in the second round. Cooney being cautioned by Mills Lane that the blow was low to the stomach. Holmes is playing a tattoo on Cooney's left eye, which is now swelling. Holmes has to be careful. So lightly regarding the opponent is Ronaldo Snipes, and this, the very round, the seventh, almost put him away with a right. Holmes is moving much more flat-footedly now. He's not using the ring the way he was earlier. Let's see if he can go 15 if he has to. Now, average loss of title for heavyweights. Age, 30 and a half years for most of the heavyweights. Holmes verging on 33. And Holmes fighting beautifully. So far, always there lurks that Cooney power. Holmes said Cooney will go in seven. We have almost gone through the seven. Where Mills Lane has problems. At least he's been lucky not to have had real problems. Tonight he doesn't have the size to cope with those two huge men. Mills Lane cautioning on a low blow. The seventh round, the eighth round. The eighth round, the round which Cooney has never gone past. The round Cooney has never had to go past. Per se, make stories, question his stamina. So somehow. Cooney is still the stalker. But so far, Cooney has not sought to do what Victor Valley begged him to do. Now, as Cooney seeks to come back, his left drop, Holmes got in with the right again. Notice that Holmes is not using the ring the way he did early. Maybe the heat, maybe a growth in his confidence because of the way he floored Cooney in the second and almost knocked him down in the sixth. Or whatever, he is not using the ring. Was hurt for a second. Out comes Cooney's mouthpiece, but he hurt Holmes. This is the eighth round, and this crowd is getting its money's worth. Cooney could sense that he had hurt him, but there's Holmes with the right. Yeah, he stands toe-to-toe with Cooney. Some of those Cooney blows, he's going to get cautioned on again. All right, Cooney with a right. Holmes fighting back, answering back, which Holmes has been doing. Cooney's mouthpiece out. Everybody's great fighting in the corner. Ninth round. More movement in the beginning of this round from Holmes. Back to his earlier state. A cut, the corner of Cooney's. Oh, good right by Cooney. Good right. Cooney trying to move in now. That cut was apparently satisfactorily handled by Gerry's corner because the flow of blood is stopped. Cooney trying to attack with a vengeance. Holmes trying to keep him off with the left jab. Oh, Cooney's, right now, Cooney's left eye is opened again, and it's a mess. It really is. It's swollen. It's ugly red. It's blood. Looking for the, that's it. I was just about to say, looking for the opportunity with the right. Knowing that Cooney has been vulnerable to that right. Two quick left jabs, doubling the left. Holmes, bridge of the nose. Open, ugly, sore. Of Holmes' left registered in Cooney's face, both the nose and the eye. Look at that left shot. More than, oh, the right again, and Cooney's knees wavered. is where experience comes in. Oh, boy. Oh. Scene speaks for itself. Cosell telling Mills Lane he's been doing it all night. Let's look at this blow now. Oh, there can be no question about that. Deduct 2 points. They are going to deduct 2 points from Gerry Cooney on this round. Let's look at it again. Hardly a question. Now let's see how much damage this has done to Larry Holmes. Fine, the 2 points have been deducted from Gerry Cooney. One seconds left in the round. Unfortunate. It's left. He's about to measure these fighters can continue to give their all this way. Cooney trying to clown a little bit. But may not be the time to do it. With DeValle implored Cooney, you've got to do it now. What Holmes should do is be wary from his point of view. Get back to that foot movement. Not get overconfident and slug it out toe to toe. Because Gerry Cooney has the power to finish Holmes at any time or anybody. What was it Joe Bugner said? Joe Frazier's left hook? It could hurt you. But Gerry Cooney's left hook goes right through you. No movement in Holmes in this round. If he's got the capacity for movement, he may be making a great mistake. We're a minute 20 seconds into the round. Round 10. Good round so far for Cooney. Good comeback round for Gerry Cooney. I see fatigue in Larry Holmes. That's why there's no movement. Larry Holmes is in trouble. He's covering. The one right, it's hardly an answer. And then another right. Cooney is fighting with a viciousness born of desperation, and he is succeeding. But he remains vulnerable to the Holmes right. This has some of the aspects of Rocky. The courage of Gerry Cooney, I'll tell you that. The left side of Cooney's face has taken a battering from Holmes's right. We're coming to the end of the 10th round. And who said Cooney didn't have stamina? That's the way for Holmes to get hurt. Toe to toe. There'll be conjecture on whether or not that terribly low blow affected Cooney's stamina and ability to move. But that's conjecture. I mean, Holmes' stamina. That's conjecture. Still, the pursuer. Holmes, the pursued. But the key, from Cooney's point of view, another low blow. He's taking another point away. It's happened too many times, according to Mills Lane. So Cooney already loses a point in this round. Cooney is not doing it intentionally, not in my view. Two quick lefts by Holmes. This is the 11th round. Holmes looking to unload his right, knowing how vulnerable Cooney has been to it. Staying in that corner, a mistake, but he's tired. Holmes is just plain tired. Heat, years, maybe low blow, all coming together. Fighting kid that his skills have overmatched, but who at any time could put him away.
Get off right, the right, the right.
There's the right. Now it's getting harder. Cooney just apologized. It's getting harder for Cooney to muster up comeback strength, because both men have had to be suffering in this heat. Coming to the end of round 11. How many of you would have thought it would go this far? Good left by Cooney. Remember Jack Sharkey? Remember Jack Sharkey? Jack Sharkey. He fought Max Schmeling and won the title on a low blow. Fourth round disqualification. I mean, he lost the title. Shut up over the complaints about the low blows. He said, I'm calling them. Low blows. There once was a disqualification. Max Schmeling won the title. Fourth round disqualification of the then champion Jack Sharkey. Low blow. Peyton Phil Scott made a career on alleged low blows. If you want to go back to the young 30s, I have no desire to. Notice the way this round started. Cooney backing up. Throughout the fight, he's been the pursuer. Round 12. This fight ends, it's going to be hard not to have a rematch with Sugar Ray Leonard sidelined, maybe forever. This fight couldn't have come along at a better time from the point of view of the quote sport unquote of boxing. Yeah. again. This is the 12th round. Oh, good pair of blows. Good three blows to the stomach of Holmes. Cooney in the late seconds. He's trying to muster up another charge. Larry without movement now. Flat-footed. The way Cooney would have liked to have seen him in the early going. Larry now trying to bounce, trying to move. It's a dangerous thing Holmes just did. He missed with the right, and his guard was down. So was his head. To the end of round 12. I'll tell you, before the start of the 13th round, that Angelo Dundee told Ray Leonard, "You're blowing it, kid, you're blowing it, you gotta do it now." And Leonard was able to come on and do it. Cooney faces that problem right now.
Get off, right there. Get off! Get it up! Wait, go right!
Seems to me, Holmes is not playing it careful. But Cooney still has that punch somewhere within him. These two men have stayed at this in this heat. Really.
Get away, get away.
Unbelievable.
Get away. Get away.
An undefeated champion. An undefeated challenge.
Get down. On the bench. On the bench. On the bench.
That was the case. With George Foreman beat Joe Frazier.
Get up! He's coming back! He's coming!
Sure the men are tired. Wouldn't you be? A 20 by 20 ring. A heat of probably over 100 degrees. Both men huge. Drawing upon every resource, physical, emotional, spiritual, the Holmes right again. Cooney still vulnerable to it. The left eye, a mess. No other way to put it. Lane properly cautioned Holmes there. He was holding Cooney's gloves with his gloves. And he was right to caution, though he did not take a point away. Now it's getting a little sloppy because both men are tired, and Holmes trying to tee off and doesn't have the strength left, I don't think, enough. Well, Jerry's ready to go. There it is. Is calling it off. Let the scene speak.
Turn off that cable, please.
In the pandemonium, Larry Holmes, by a technical knockout, has retained his WBC heavyweight championship of the world. A grueling, enduring fight. with the challenger as game as they come, without the boxing skills and experience that belong to Holmes, without the ability to negotiate the ring that belonged to Holmes for most of the fight. This is the way it was, and undoubtedly there will be a rematch. Now let's take a look at the last flurry. At first I didn't think Holmes had the strength left to finish off Cooney. It was clear that he was peppering him almost at will. Gerry finally could take no more. He need not be ashamed. He's just a kid. Didn't have that many fights. 25. Only fought 6 rounds in the last 2 years. And still put forth a very great, courageous effort. Victor Valley, who ultimately came out. No more exhortations between rounds to his fighter. No more get rough. This was a knockdown. The count had begun.
Take it easy, man. You and the new man.
And there is Larry Holmes.
Good job.
And I'm waiting for Larry Holmes, exhausted, but obviously inwardly exuberant, to come down and talk with me. There is Gerry Cooney. Need apologize to nobody. After all, Gerry remembers Rocky lost the first time to Apollo Creed. Holmes appears emotionally spent.
All
right, we're trying now, ladies and gentlemen, to get Larry Holmes down here. The scoring up to the point the fight stopped was unanimously in favor of Holmes. 113 to 111 by Dave Ford. 113 to 111, surprisingly close by Dave Moretti. Gerry Roth had it about where I had it. 115 to 109 for Gerry Holmes. Well, it appears that we will have the official decision. Here is
ladies and gentlemen, the time, 2 minutes 52 seconds of the 13th round, the winner and still the WBC heavyweight champion of the world, Larry Holmes.
So there was the official decision, the pandemonium, the melee. Larry Holmes not able to get down here at the moment. Good night, everyone. Larry Holmes, the winner.
Productions and Tiffany Promotions, Sam Glass, president, in association with Caesar's Palace. Executive producer, Don King. Produced by Chet Forty. Directed by Joe Assetti. Technical director, John Allen. Associate producer, Alex Wallow. Associate directors, Norm Samet, Paulette Douglas. Assistants to the producers, Earl Woody Fryman and Jay Moses. Production assistants, David Allen Burnson. Research, Bob Yalen. The preceding program is protected by